Hi, my name is Winnie. Today I'm going to show you about the culture of Japan.
First, group orientation. In Japanese society, the individual has traditionally derived identity from group affiliation, including family, school, and company. The concept of wa, which means harmony, is important in Japanese society. The society values harmonious relations within a group over the individual. Negative emotions are not allowed to be expressed openly. The second culture is hierarchy. In the collective relationship-oriented culture in Japan, respecting and maintaining hierarchical relationship is essential in social and business. Importance of hierarchy in Japan culture is based in the social ethics of Confucianism, in which people are ordered in hierarchical relationship. The Japanese believe that a stable society depends on the proper maintenance of this hierarchical relationship. For example, customer is higher than the vendor, manager is higher than the subordinate. The next one is high context communication. When Japanese communicate with each other, it is therefore not necessary to verbalize everything explicitly. Since there is a shared background, a kind of shorthand can be used. Feelings can be communicated with few words or through subtle non-verbal cues. There is a Japanese saying, hear one, understand ten. Silence can also have great meaning. One of the main culture issues is Japanese company take a long time to make decision. Japanese company make decision based on the culture value of group orientation. Decision tend to make by group conscience rather than individual authority. This decision making process has a formal manifestation called the ringing system. The ringing system consists of a writing proposal which is circulated among all the people who were affected by the decision based on hierarchy, starting lower in the organization and work its way up. When the ringing proposal reaches each person's desk, they read it, sometimes make a few adjustments, and then they put their personal seal on it. Before they sign off on a proposal, consensus building starts with informal, face-to-face discussion. This process of informally making a proposal, getting input, and solidified support is called nimawashi. Nimawashi in a Japanese organization protects the decision-making from damage such as disagreement or lack of commitment. One of the benefits is smoother implementation. Everyone is aware with the decision, most people agree with it, and more careful planning has taken place. The second cultural issue is Japanese do not always say what they mean. People from high context cultures such as Japan will sometimes choose implicit non-verbal communication over explicit verbal communication. They may feel that verbal communication is too blunt or unnecessarily obvious, whereas expressing yourself non-verbally is more subtle and considerate. Japanese sometimes seems to say one thing and then do another because they are withholding their personal opinion or true feeling in the public setting of the meeting, voicing only the official line in order to keep the harmony of the situation. Japanese has an expression for one type of laugh, aisowarashi, which can be translated as polite laugh. The meaning of polite laugh can be considered as do not understand the English being spoken or the reluctance of the Japan to give a direct negative response. Last but not least, a foreign businessman noted that the Japanese tend to use inaction or to give no response to indicate disagreement. The Japanese desire to maintain relationship by avoiding confrontation often lead them to give ambiguous response which are misinterpreted by foreigners, causing misunderstanding and sometimes bad feeling. Thank you.
So this is some Japanese business culture, and I hope you to enjoy this video, and thank you for watching it.